Hello everyone, once again I welcome you all to our YouTube channel Engineering Shiksha. So in this lecture we are continuing with our transient analysis in RL and RC circuit. So in this lecture we are going to solve some more numerical that is based on first order differential equation. So our target audience for this particular lecture, that is the undergraduate and diploma students, those who are preparing for their end sem examination. So the branches that we are going to cover for this particular lecture, that is electrical, electronics and IC branch. This is obviously this is also helpful for all the other students, those who are preparing for GATE and other competitive exam. So with this, let's start our lectures. So this is the note that you have to or must be remember whenever you are solving your first order differential equation. So this is the note here you must have to be remember. Whenever you are having a first order differential equation in the form of dx by dt plus px equal to q, so solution of that equation could be x equal to e raised to minus pt integration q e raised to pt plus k e raised to minus pt, where x or value of x could be anything, that could be maybe possible voltage and current in case of you are solving your equation in form of RL or RC circuit. Remember friend, when you are encountered this type of equation, that is dx by dt plus px equal to q, you are encountering this equation whenever you are solving your first order differential equation. It means that whenever you are having R, L, N in the series of the circuit, so whenever you are applying KVL or maybe possible you are applying KCL, and if you are encountering the two variables or two, let us say a component, that is R or L or maybe R and C, in that particular case your equation could be in form of dx by dt plus px equal to q. Remember that this is when you are encountering a three element, that is R, L and C in series, or maybe possible R, L, C, that is in case of the parallel circuit, your equation could be a second order differential equation, and you can find out that d square x by dt square, something like that. But that we are going to discuss after one or two lectures. So let us discuss the steps that you have to follow whenever we are having this type of situation, that is the first order differential equation. So the first step, you have to draw the equivalent circuit for T0-. T0- means just before the switching, and you have to calculate the voltage and current as per your requirement. So if circuit or if your example, you have to calculate the voltage, then you have to calculate the voltage across the capacitor or maybe possible inductor, or you have to calculate the current flowing through inductor just before the switching. So this is the first step that you have to follow, and you have to calculate based on your requirement these two variables. Then after that you have to draw the equivalent circuit for t greater than 0, and you have to apply the KVL, or you can say that a combination of KCL or node voltage analysis. So suppose you have to calculate the current, in most of the time when you have to calculate the current expression for t greater than 0, we are applying a KVL. And whenever you have to calculate the voltage, then at that time we are going to apply a KCL or maybe possible node voltage analysis to solve our example. In the third step, what we are doing, we are using the generalized solution of first order differential equation. That is what dx by dt plus px equal to q. So in the third step, we have directly utilized this generalized solution that we obtained in our last class. Then in the next step, we have to calculate a particular solution. The reason is that when you are applying the generalized solution, you are having one term, that is constant k. To obtain the constant k, what you have to do, you have to consider your initial condition. Initial condition means at the time of switching. Let us say we are doing the switching at instant t equal to 0. Then what we have to do, we have to use this generalized expression. You have to use this generalized equation, and in this generalized equation we will put the value of t equal to 0. When you put the value of t equal to 0, you can find out the constant k by considering your initial condition. It means that you already calculate the parameter in first step. So by utilizing this voltage and current parameters, and you have to put that value of parameter in your generalized solution for t equal to 0 or maybe possible at the instant of switching, you can calculate the constant k. So now let us start our today's first example. In the network of figure, the switch K is in position A. So my switch K is in position A. So let me mark here, this is your switch K, it is in position A for a long period of time. And at time t equal to 0, this switch is moved from position A to position B. And what I have to obtain, I have to obtain the expression for voltage V to t for t greater than and equal to 0. It means that I have to calculate the voltage, okay, between these two terminals Okay, that is given that that is equal to V to T. So students, remember that the thing is in example it is given that the switch K is in position A for a long period of time. For a long period of time means what? This switch is in position A and it is attain a steady state, though it is not mentioned, but it is given that it is at position A for a very long period of time. So if it is very long period of time, what I have to do? I have to consider for this particular inductor state that is equal to T equal to infinite. Okay, I will remind you once again. Let us say morning 7 a.m. I am connecting this circuit. Okay, and at that time switch is in position A, and I have start to calculate my example. Let us say some another instant. Let us say 9 a.m. Okay, it is given that switch is in position A for a long period of time. Okay, so let us say at morning 7 a.m. I am connecting this circuit. Okay, at that time my inductor was behave as a open circuit. That is the time at T equal to zero for the inductor case. But right now it is given that you move the switch from position A to B at time T equal to zero. Okay, this is switching time, and that is equal to what time? That is equal to 9 a.m. So it means that at 9 a.m. what I am doing? I am actually shifting this switch from position A to B. And my switch is in position A for a long period of time. Okay, so it means that my inductor is fully charged. Maybe possible, let us say after 7 a.m. few microsecond or few millisecond, after that my inductor is fully charged. So it means that if I am observing this circuit at 9 a.m. my inductor is fully charged. So let me write down here the situation that, let us say at time T equal to 0 minus. At time T equal to 0 minus means what? Just before the switching. So if it means that if I am doing my switching at, let us say 9 a.m. few microsecond before the switching. So what will be the condition? Condition is that I am having one voltage source. Okay, I am having one resistance, and this inductor is fully charged because it was connected at 7 a.m. and I am analyzing my circuit at, let us say 9 a.m. So just few microsecond before 9 a.m. my inductor will behave as a short circuit, right? So this is my equivalent circuit. Okay, I am having one voltage source, resistance, and this is my inductor, and my inductor is behave as a short circuit. Okay, this is very important. You have to remember this thing and never be confused with whether inductor will behave as an open circuit or short circuit. So now let us say in this particular case, if I am going to calculate the current that is flowing through inductor, that is, let us say IL 0 minus. So that is equal to how much? So I am having a 1 volt and I am having 1 ohm resistance. So I will get the current that is flowing through my inductor just before the switching. It means that prior, let us say for our case, if I am saying that my switching is at instant 9 a.m. So few microsecond before 9 a.m. if I am going to put a multimeter or if I am going to put the ammeter, and if I am going to calculate the current that is flowing through in this particular case, then what I will get? I will get IL 0 minus, that is equal to 1 ampere. Okay. Now let us discuss about that, what exactly happened at time T greater than 0. So at time T greater than 0, this is my equivalent circuit, right? My switch is moved from position 1 to B. Okay, my switch is moved from position 1 to B. So it means that this inductor, actually this is the charge inductor, will actually shift now from position 1 to B. Okay, so this is my situation that this inductor is now connected to terminal B. So I have drawn this circuit once again over here. My inductor is shifting from position A to position B. So this is the situation I can say that at time, okay, this is, let me write down, this is at time T greater than N0. So my switch is in position number B. Okay, now in this case I have to calculate the voltage. So what could be the best way if you want to calculate the voltage? You have to apply first of all KCL, and then after that you can apply a node voltage analysis. So let me write down that some current is flowing this branch. Okay, let us mention this current, let us say that is equal to I1. Some current is flowing through this particular resistive branch, that is, let us say I2. And some current is flowing through this third inductor, let us mention that is equal to I3. So if at this node, let me write down the name of this node, let us say node A. At node A, if I am applying a KCL, what I will get? I will get that is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3, that is equal to 0, right? Okay. Now let us calculate, or now let me elaborate what is the value of I1. I1 is current flowing through inductor. So current flowing through inductor, how we can calculate? So current flowing through inductor, that is L di by dt, right? No, that is voltage across the inductor. Current flowing through inductor is 1 by L. So in this particular case, 1 by L, and let us write down the I1. I1 is current flowing through 1 ohm inductor. So 1 by L, where value of L is also equal to 1. So 1 by L integration. Now potential at this terminal. So potential at this terminal, can I say that that is V2? Because this is ultimately short branch. So potential at this branch is also equal to V2. Potential at this branch is also equal to V2. Potential at this branch is also equal to V2. And this is my reference branch. So I can say that potential at this branch is 0 volt. So it means that here also I am having, let us say, 0 volt. Okay. So this is my 0 volt. So let me write down 1 by L integration VDT. V is the potential difference across this inductor. So 1 by L integration. Now potential difference is what? V2 minus 0. So I can write down that is V2 minus 0 dt. Agree? Plus, let me write down I2. I2 is what? Current flowing through this particular resistance. So I can write down that is equal to potential difference between these two terminals. That is V2 minus 0. So I can say that is V2 minus 0. Divide by resistance. The value of resistance is given. That is 1 by 2. Then I3. So let me write down I3. That is 1 by L. The value of L is given. That is also equal to how much? So that is equal to 2. So I can write down that is 1 by 2. Integration. Now potential difference between these two terminal of this inductor, so that is V2 minus 0, so that is V2 minus 0 dt, that is equal to 0. So this is my expression. Now what I have to do, I have to simplify this expression. So remember, friends, what we are having, one solution, that is dx by dt plus px equal to q. It means that if I am having, this is first order differential equation, then I can solve it. But right now this is integration. So let me differentiate also this equation. So let me differentiate this equation. So what I will get? Integration V2 and differentiation V2. So I will get only V2, right? Plus, now this is 1 by 2. It means that 2V2, and differentiation of 2V2 is dV2 by dt plus 1 by 2. Now integration differentiation get cancelled, so I will get 1 by 2 V2, that is equal to 0, right? Now let me further simplify this. So remember, we are having, or we must require equation in form of dx by dt plus px equal to q. And now this equation is not in that particular form. It is having some constant value 2 also. So let us divide by 2. So what I will get, that is equal to dV2 by dt. Okay, I am just dividing by 2 in this whole equation. So I will get dV2 by dt plus, this is V2 by 2. I am dividing by 2, and this is V2 by 4, that is equal to 0, right? So now this is V2 by 2 and V2 by 4. So this is equal to 3V2 by 4. So this is dV2 by dt plus, this is 3V2 by 4. That is equal to 0. So if I am comparing this equation with our generalized form, that is, let me write down here, my generalized form is dx by dt plus px, that is equal to q. So in this particular case, if you want to finding out the solution of this equation, then your solution could be like this. I is equal to, or x is equal to, e raised to minus pt integration q e raised to pt plus k e raised to minus pt. So if I'm applying this rule over here, and if I'm going to calculate what is the value of p, then you have to compare these two equation. So when you are comparing these two equation, you will get the value of p, that is equal to 3 by 4, right? And what is the value of q? Q is also equal to 0. So let me write down this equation. So this is not I for this particular case, this is V. So let me write down the variable, that is V2 equal to. Now if I will observe this equation, e raised to minus pt integration q, and value of q is 0. So if you put value of q is 0, this whole term is going to be 0. So it means that I will get, that is equal to k e raised to minus, the value of p is 3 by 4. Okay. So that is e raised to minus 3 by 4 into t. This is what my generalized expression. So So we also discussed that how to calculate this value of k, because this is just a generalized solution. You have to calculate a particular solution. So whenever you want to solve the particular equation, what you have to consider? Our fourth step, we have to consider the initial condition. So you have to put at time, so let us say at time t equal to 0. So at time t equal to 0, so you put the value of t equal to 0 in this equation. So when you put the value of t equal to 0 in this equation, what you will get? You will get that v2 that is equal to k e raised to 0. Okay, or you can also mention that v2 at 0 time. So let me write down, this is v2 at 0 time, that is equal to k into e raised to 0. So it means that what is the value of constant k? So value of constant k is equal to, you can say that is equal to v2 at this terminal. It means that I can say that this voltage at 0 instant, that is equal to your value of constant k. But if you observe our previous slide, if you observe this previous slide, we have calculated only IL0 minus. We have not calculated V2 0 plus. Okay. So now let me calculate V2 0 plus. So let me draw this circuit again. So we will consider now, let us say at time t greater than 0, or you can say that at t equal to 0 plus time. It means that just after the switching. Why I am doing this? I want to calculate this voltage V2 0 plus. Okay, so can I say that the current flowing through this particular inductor, that is equal to how much? That is equal to 1 ampere. Okay, and what about this resistance? So it is having a value, let us say 1/2 ohm. Now let me discuss about the very important point. What could be the value, or what is the status of this inductor which is having a value that is equal to 2 Henry? Whether it will behave as an open circuit at time t equal to 0 plus, or whether it will behave as a short circuit. At 9 a.m. this inductor is fully charged, right? And this will move to your position number B, right? But what about this 2 Henry inductor? This inductor come in contact with the energy. Okay, this inductor is having some energy and it will come in contact with the energy. This 2 Henry inductor will come in contact with this energy first time. So it means that at time t equal to 0 plus time, this inductor will behave as a open circuit, right? And I want to calculate this voltage V2 0. How I can calculate the voltage V2 0? This is the parallel branch, right? So whatever the voltage drop across this resistance, okay, this is plus, this is minus. Whatever the voltage drop across this resistance, that is equal to my V2 0 plus, right? Okay, now let me write down, or let me clarify this point. Why I am considering this 1 ampere, this inductor? So remember that before the switching, current flowing through inductor, that is equal to how much? That is equal to 1 ampere. And we know very well and very carefully that inductor always opposes the instantaneous change in current. And current which is flowing through inductor, just before the switching and just after the switching, that will remain same. So it means that if I'm saying that current flowing through this inductor, that is equal to 1 ampere, right? Just before 9 a.m. So just after the 9 a.m, the current flowing through inductor will remain is equal to how much? That is equal to also 1 ampere. So if I'm applying KVL, this is 1 ampere and this is 1/2 ohm. So this is the direction of current. So what I will get, this plus and this minus, and how much voltage drop across this resistance, that is equal to 1/2 into current flowing through this branch, that is equal to 1 ampere. So it means that I will get that is equal to 1/2 volt, right? It means that V20 plus, that is equal to how much? So that is equal to 1/2. Now one very important thing, remember what we observe, we want this terminal plus and this terminal minus. And drop that we are obtaining, or that we are calculating, this terminal is plus and this terminal is minus. So that's why it means that V20 plus, that is equal to minus 1/2. So in this particular case, what is V20 plus? So that is ultimately our constant K. So this V20 plus, that is our constant K, and that is equal to 1/2. So if I will put this, I will get the final expression, that is V2, that is equal to 1/2 e raised to minus 3/4 into t. So this is our final expression, V2 equal to 1/2 e raised to minus 3/4 t. This is our answer. So now let us discuss our next example. So in the network of figures, steady state is reached with the switch K is open. So it means that my switch is open and I have achieved the steady state. Okay, again, this is the same example. My capacitor for this particular case, what could be the condition that it will behave as a T equal to infinite state. So at T equal to infinite, my capacitor is fully charged. Okay. So, and when capacitor is fully charged, it will behave as a open or short. Remember, capacitor will behave as a open circuit, right? So at time t equal to 0, so this is switching time, switch K is closed. So this switch K is closed. So find the voltage expression for capacitor VCT for t greater than 0. Okay, so now let us consider at time t equal to 0 minus. T equal to 0 minus means just before the switching. So let me take one example. Let us say we are doing this switching at let us say 10 a.m. Okay. So just before or some microsecond before 10 a.m. What is the condition? This switch is open, right? What about this capacitor? Okay, maybe possible we have connected this circuit, let us say 7 a.m. Okay, and at that time capacitor will behave as an open circuit and it will start charging, and finally, let us say after some microsecond, it will behave as a open circuit. Remember, okay, so capacitor is attained the steady state, and for this particular capacitor, the state could be equal to T equal to infinite. So at time T equal to 0 minus, capacitor is fully charged, and this capacitor will behave as a open circuit, right? So this is my equivalent circuit. In this particular case, this switch is open, so this branch should not be taken into the consideration. So this is my situation, and I want to calculate this voltage, that is VC0 minus. So let me first of all calculate the current that is flowing through this branch. Okay, so let me write down current, that is I0 minus, that is equal to, so voltage that I'm going to apply, that is 5 volt, total resistance, this is 1 ohm, this is also 1 ohm, and this is 1/2 ohm. So this is actually 2.5 ohms. So this is, let us say, 2.5 ohms. So what I will get? 2.5 into 5. So this is my 2 ampere. So it means that this current I is equal to how much? That is equal to 2 ampere. And remember, this situation is just before the switching. It means that, let us say I'm doing my switching at 10 a.m. So few microsecond before the switching, if I'm going to measure this current, then it is equal to 2 ampere. Okay, now let me calculate voltage across the capacitor, VC0 minus. What could be the value of VC0 minus? It is 5 volt? No. VC0, how I can calculate the VC0 minus? So I have to consider the drop across this resistance. So 2 ampere current is flowing through this resistor. It means that out of 5 volt, 2 ohm into 2 ampere, so that is equal to 2 volt will be dropped across this resistance. So it means that voltage drop or voltage I will get across this capacitor, that is equal to how much? That is equal to 3 volt. Remember, VC0 is not equal to 5 volt. The reason is that there will be a one close path. Okay, and this current is equal to how much? 2 ampere. So 2 ampere into 1 ohm. So that will be 2 volt. So it means that 2 volt will be dropped across this resistance. So it means that at this terminal, I will get only equal to how much? That is equal to 3 volt. So this capacitor will charge to your 3 volt only. So this is my capacitor voltage at time t equal to 0 minus. Now let me discuss the next step, that is I have closing this switch. And when I am closing the switch, I have to find out the expression for VCT. Okay, so this is my equivalent circuit for t equal to 0 plus time. So I have closing the switch. So this is my, let us say, at t greater than 0 time. Okay, so at t greater than 0 time, my switch is closed. Okay, I have to calculate or find out the voltage across capacitor, and let me consider this node voltage, that is equal to V. Remember, friend, whenever we have to calculate the voltage, we generally apply a node voltage analysis. So before, first of all, we'll apply a KCL, and after that we will apply a node voltage analysis. So let us consider some current is flowing through this branch. Let us mark it as I1. Some current is flowing through this branch, I2, and some current is flowing through this branch, let us say I3. So I can say that I1 plus I2 plus I3, that is equal to 0. What is I1? I1 is current flowing through this branch. So potential difference of this particular branch, this is VC, and potential at this, that is equal to 5. So I can say that VC minus 5. So VC minus 5 divided by resistance of this, that is equal to 1. What is I2? I2 is current flowing through capacitor. So that is C dV by dt, right? So value of C, that is equal to 1 by 2 d by dt of potential difference. Potential difference is Vc minus 0. So I can write down this is Vc because potential at this is 0 volt. So Vc minus 0. So I have just write down Vc only plus Vc, and we require a potential at this. So I am assuming that this is equal to V. So Vc minus V divided by 1 by 2. Okay, that is equal to 0. So if I will simplify this further, what I will get, that is equal to 1 by 2 dVc by dt plus this is Vc and this is 2Vc. So I will get 3Vc minus 2V, that is equal to, if I will take this minus 5 on right hand side, I will get that is equal to 5. Now in this equation, if I'm observing this equation, I am two variables. The first, that is Vc, that I want to calculate, and second unknown is my potential at this node V. So I also require to calculate the potential at this node V. So for this particular purpose, I have to apply the node voltage analysis once again. So let me apply a node voltage analysis once again. So now let us apply our KCL, or let us apply first of all node voltage analysis at this node. So let me write down some current. Let us say some current is flowing through this branch. Let me mark I1. Some current is flowing through this branch. Let us say I2. And some current is flowing through this branch. Let us say I3. So I can say that is equal to I1 plus I2 plus, I can say that is I3, that is equal to 0. Okay, what is I1? I1 is current flowing through this branch. So I can say that potential difference, current is flowing from V to Vc. So I can say that is V minus Vc divided by resistance, that is equal to 1 by 2. Plus I2 is the potential difference between these two. Okay, potential difference between the terminal of this resistance divided by resistance. So at this terminal, we are having V potential. At this terminal, we are having 0 volt potential. So V minus 0. So this is only V. Divide by resistance, that is equal to 1. Now let me write down I3. I3 is the voltage drop across, or you can say that across this terminal. Okay, so that is V, and potential at this terminal is equal to how much? That is 5. So I can say that is V minus 5 divided by 2. That is equal to, I can say that is equal to 0. So if you simplify this, you will get 7V minus 4Vc, that is equal to 5. Or you can say that V, that is equal to 4 by 7 Vc plus 5 by 7. Now we have to put this value of V in this particular equation. So what we will get, I will directly write down this. So final expression could be like this: dVc by dt plus 26 by 7 Vc, that is equal to 90 divided by 7. So if I will further simplify this, what I will get? I will get dVc by dt and 4 Vc, that is equal to 12.86. Now, if I will compare this equation with our generalized first order equation, that is dx by dt plus px equal to q. This is our generalized equation. If we compare with our generalized equation, we will get a value of p in this particular case, that is equal to 3.714. And what is the value of q? Q, that is equal to 12.86. So this is the value of P and this is the value of Q. What could be our first order generalized solution? The solution is that X is equal to e raised to minus PT integration Q e raised to PT plus K into e raised to minus PT. Now I have already obtained the value of P. I already have obtained the value of Q. So I will put these two values in this particular equation. And what is X for my particular case? That is equal to Vc. So let me write down here, voltage across capacitor Vc, that is equal to e raised to minus, what is the value of P? 3.714. So that is 3.714 into t integration q. What is the value of q? So that is 12.86 e raised to pt. So this is 3.714 into t plus k into e raised to minus pt. So minus p means 3.714 into t. If you further simplify, we will get Vc is equal to e raised to minus 3.714 t. Then 12.86 is constant, so you will take out of integration, so 12.86. Now e raised to x, so we will get e raised to 3.714 t. Okay, this is the integration of e raised to x only. Now let us integrate the power, so we will get 3.714 plus k into e raised to minus 3.714 t. So I will get Vc that is equal to, now e raised to minus xt and e raised to plus xt. So this two term, okay, e raised to minus 3.7143 and e raised to plus 3.714, that is equal to 1. So what I will get, that is 12.86 divided by 3.714 plus k into e raised to minus 3.714t. So voltage across capacitor Vc, that is equal to 3.462 plus k into e raised to minus 3.714t. This is our generalized expression. If you want to calculate the particular solution, what you have to do, you have to put the value of t equal to 0. So let me put value of t equal to 0 in this equation, then I will get my value of constant k. So let me put the value of t equal to 0 in the above expression. So what I will get, Vc0 that is equal to 3.462 plus k. Now e raised to 0 is 1. So e raised to 0 is 1. So I can write down that is equal to 1. Now I require to calculate Vc0. What is the value of capacitor at time t equal to 0? We already calculated this thing. Okay. Vc0 that is equal to 3 volt. This is prior to switching. But remember, in case of capacitor, before the switching and after the switching, voltage across capacitor will remain same. So it means that in this particular case also, Vc0 equal to how much? That is equal to 3 volt. So let me write down Vc0 plus, okay, this is after the switching, that is equal to 3. So 3, and this is 3.462 plus k. So it means that value of k, that is equal to 0.462. If you take on the left hand side and this is on the right side, you will get here minus sign. So this is 3 minus 3.462. So your final answer is minus 0.462. So it means that my final particular solution Vc, that is equal to 3.462 minus 0.462 e raised to minus 3.714 t. This is my voltage of expression, voltage across the capacitor for t greater than 0. Okay, so this is my expression for voltage across capacitor. This is also known as particular solution. So by using this equation, you can calculate the voltage across capacitor at different interval, but by just putting the value of t equal to 0, t equal to infinite, or any specific value that given in your example. So I hope you found this lecture very interesting. Thank you.